In this video, you'll learn about the associative selection model, working with the selection menu, and working with the selection bar. When you make selections with Qlik Sense, you are doing more than just filtering data. You are revealing associations which help promote discovery. Qlik Sense holds a model of your data and how it is interrelated. Making selections provides visual indicators that help you easily see what values are selected, what values are possible, what values are alternative, and what values are excluded. These relationships are indicated with colors: green, white, and shades of gray. This is what we call the associative selection model. If you select a region, for example, Japan, you can see that the city table updates. The items in white indicate which cities are part of the selected region. The items that are not included are highlighted in dark gray. At the same time, in the customer table, you can see the customers related to the selected region. The light gray indicates that there are other possible selections. By selecting another item, you can now see the changes to the other tables. If I deselect an item, the tables update accordingly. This association concept works with any selection, and you can use any element in the app. It is not necessary to go down a linear path. So if, for example, you want to see the customers related to a particular city, you can select the city from the list and the fields will update accordingly. The selected item is now colored in green. In white are all the possibilities related to the selection you've made. That is, all the customers related to this particular city. In light gray are all the other possible selections that you can make. In dark gray are all the excluded values. The region items are also updated, so you can see with which region the city you've selected is associated. This association model color scheme is used in all selection tools at your disposal in Qlik Sense. It helps you to quickly understand the associations in your data. Qlik Sense provides you with a powerful tool to aid you in the selection process. This is the selection menu. If you go to the menu and click Select Possible, all the possible values that were colored white now become green. Clicking Excluded selects alternative values. The values that were previously selected change their status to alternative. With the Select Alternative option, the fields marked in light gray will be selected, and the values that were previously selected become alternative instead. When we click Select All, the alternative values change their state to selected and are colored in green. The excluded values will be selected, as you can see by the check mark, but will still be excluded. If you clear the selections which made these values excluded, they will change their state to selected. During data analysis, the selections are displayed above the sheet. Each selection item has a small bar at the bottom that reflects the selection states for that dimension. Three states are displayed in the bars: selected, green; alternative, light gray; and excluded, dark gray. As you can see, when you open the selection item, you have the same selection options as you had with the selection menu. You can select and deselect items, clear selections, and lock your selections. The lock prevents any changes from being made to your selections. You can neither change nor clear a locked selection. However, you can still modify your selections in other elements of your visualization. In the selections bar, you can step back in the selection history. In this example, the selections for region are now locked again. You can move back or forward even if a selection has been locked. But if you click the Clear All Selections button, you can remove all selections except the ones that are locked. If you want to select a specific field, you can type its name directly in the search box and click on the name of the field to select it. The same functionality is available in the current selections bar. When you are working with filter panes, you can adjust them to best suit your analysis requirements. In this dashboard sheet, you can see how they are used. The sheet keeps the selections that have already been made. You can clear them directly in the toolbar. Filter panes have other selection capabilities, even if they are reduced in size, as seen in this example. If you select 2014 in the year filter pane, you'll see a green line that indicates the selection, while the light gray line indicates that there are other possible selections you can make. In the quarter filter pane, the gray color indicates that there are no data related to the third and fourth quarters for the selected year. This functionality helps you get an overview of your data because you can rapidly understand that these fields contain data you have selected, data you can select, and data that does not exist or that is not related to this selection. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.